Hi, everybody. In our private TSA group, we were having a conversation today where one of our members had put out an offer, she said, and there was crickets. Nobody responded. Nobody signed up, right? And so it started a very good conversation about when you're a business owner, right? And when you're providing services, even for kids, right? Which we know kids need help with a lot of different things related to learning. It doesn't mean that people will always sign up for what it is you have to offer right away. So I wanted to give you guys some tips and some things to look for. If you are making an offer, you're structuring either like your tutoring or a class or a small group or a club. Gosh, there's so many ways to help kids when you are working for yourself and when you have like an independent like education business, right? And so I wanted you to think about a couple different things when you are planning what you would like to offer, because if nobody is signing up, it's not just one thing. It doesn't mean it's a horrible offer. There are four different things that you should be looking at to see. Maybe you need to tweak it just a little bit to be able to create something that people actually want. Now, you might hear something in the background because I decided to record on my porch today because it's a beautiful day out. So we probably need to do more trainings out here on the porch, right? So if you hear somebody doing a cannonball in the pool, that's why. So first things first. A lot of times we like to share our services, share that we have new tutoring spots that are opening, or we might say, you know what, I've moved to full-time tutoring, or I'm doing this cool thing in the summer, right? And we put it out there and nothing happens, right? And we think, okay, it's a bust. But you guys, you have to be able to think beyond that first time you're sharing something, because it is a busy world out there. There is a lot of information coming at us at all times. And so I want to make sure that the first thing you do is you actually share your offer many times in many different ways with as many people as you possibly can. Don't just put it out there and think, I built it, they will come. It's not like Field of Dreams, right? You have to actually get in front of people, and you need to do it more than once. They might see this thing that you're doing and think it's really cool, but we already know something else is going to come along that's going to get our attention. So make sure that you're giving plenty of time to share about the services that, or the service, that whatever it is you're offering. Make sure you give plenty of time for people to learn about it, think about it, come back to it, see it, and then finally they might decide to sign up. So just because people don't sign up right away does not mean it's a bust and that nobody wants it. But let's say you have been sharing it in a couple different ways and you're still not getting people to sign up, okay? Well, it could be one of four things, okay? It could be the offer itself. So you thought people would really like this, right? Whether it's a writing class, a writing club, a math class, math tutoring, reading tutoring, science tutoring. It could be so many different things, right? So maybe whatever it was that you created, you thought people would like. But maybe the what you thought they would like is not actually what they really needed. And so when you are thinking about these four things, I want you to go and ask people around you who are the people you're trying to reach. Ask them what could help you right now. So right now we are going through some big shifts, and we have families that are suddenly going to be teaching their kids at home, especially this fall, that hadn't planned on it. And so something that you might think is really helpful, number one, they might not even know that they need it. But number two, that might not actually be the biggest thing that they need right now. So when you think about that offer, ask around and say, is this something that would be helpful for you? If not, what would be helpful for you? Because really, we need to share things that are going to help the people that are around us, right? So it's not about convincing them that what we're doing is cool. It's about making sure that we create a service that fills the gap, that fills the need that the families in our community or online, the needs that they have, right? So first, look at your offer and see, is it actually what people want? And if it isn't, what can you do to tweak it? And it might just be that it needs to be more narrowed down and specific, or it might be that it needs to be broader. It might be your approach. It might be that it needs to be kind of like less structured or more structured, more of a club, or more of like replacing traditional learning lessons and things like that. Okay, so number two, I want you to think about your structure, Okay, so let's say you know that you've got some really cool things that you can do for writing. You're a fantastic writing teacher, and let's face it, a lot of us need really fantastic writing teachers. Well, look at the structure of what it is that you're offering, okay? So you can do writing that's one-on-one, where you're really helping one child. You can do a class or a group where it's still very structured, like you're teaching them very specific writing skills. Or you could be doing a writing club where it's less about the mechanics of writing and more about the joy of writing and sharing your message and your story. And it's less about the formal things and more about building these little writing communities. So if one thing isn't working, maybe it's that people are looking for something that's a little bit more of like a club. Or maybe you're doing a club and they were looking for something that's a little bit more structured. So look at that class you're offering and think, is there a way to restructure this that maybe can meet the needs of families a little bit more? And again, all of this takes experimentation, asking around, trying things out. You won't necessarily figure this out the first day. Okay, the third thing to look at is the schedule. So look at other things happening in your community if it's an in-person offer. And then if it's not, and if it's online, just kind of look at the other just other things that are competing for that time and attention, okay? So for your schedule, it could be the time of day, it could be the day of the week, maybe there's a bunch of other things going on that day. It could be something as simple as how often you meet and how long you meet, right? So maybe a once a week class would work really well for some families, but for other families, they might actually want more. They might want you to do something two or three times a week because maybe they want that class to really kind of close a lot of the gaps on learning, or that group or that tutoring or whatever that is, right? So I've done writing clubs in the past over the summer, and I know that some families would rather do like a writing club where it's like half a day, but for 1 week at a time. So for 1 week, it's almost like a writing camp, right? And then other families might prefer to come every week, but just come one afternoon a week. That way they're kind of writing all summer long. And so again, that offer, that structure, the way that I would structure that schedule, some people couldn't sign up because I did it 1 day a week all summer long, and just the way their vacations lined up, it didn't work. For others, if I were to block off a whole week and make it a writing camp, they might not be able to commit to taking a whole week to dedicate just to that. So that's another thing to look at. And again, the best way to find out what's going to land and work, other than offering and seeing what happens, is to ask around. And then finally, price. So it takes some navigating and figuring out to kind of figure out your sweet spot for how to price either your private services, like as a tutor. And in TSA, we actually go through a lot of different specific ways of coming up with your prices that actually involve kind of like reverse engineering your income and looking at, you know, your expenses and different factors and things like that. But when it comes to like an offer, like a class or a group, sometimes it's going to take a little bit of time to figure out, can you charge a higher amount? Do you need to charge it slightly less? What do comparative like classes and things like that cost? And so I've done offers in the past where I charged it at one price, nobody signed up for it. And then I tweaked it and I just made it like $5 less and everybody purchased it. So in that case, it's like that second price was something that was just, they weren't able to turn down. They were like, you know what, that's perfect, let's do it. And then when I had the original price, it just made them go, you know, I wasn't really committed to investing that amount right now. So it takes some time to figure out what is going to be the best price for groups, classes, clubs, and then your individual tutoring. So again, you're going to have to try these things out. Take notes, see it, like see what changes you make, what kind of responses you get. Track where you're sharing it, who you're sharing it with, and which things actually get people to respond to, because then you want to do more of that. So number one, look at those four different factors to see, is there something that needs to be tweaked so that what you have to offer actually can help the families you want to help, right? But two, if you're not really sure what to fix, start asking people. I know it's scary to reach out and ask people and talk to people. Don't say, you didn't sign up, why don't you like it? Don't do it like that, you guys. Come on, like, let's be smart about it. Just ask around and say, hey, I'm thinking of doing this writing class or this course or this club. Does this sound like something that could be helpful to you? If not, is there something else I could be doing? And just ask people around you. People want help. people probably want your help. We just have to kind of figure out what it is, how to like kind of mix and marry what you have to offer with what families need. So look at those the next time you are offering something and you feel like you hear crickets.